2005. I'm off for the holiday weekend, no beeper, and not a chance of being called back to the hospital. My boys, now 12 and 14, have gone to see War of the Worlds. So tonight, I'm flying solo. The evening is glorious. The sky painted orange and red as the sun nestles into the horizon. Mosquito hawks swirl in the bright fluorescent lights of Novato Horsemen's Arena. And tonight, for the first time, I'll be competing on my own horse, Dr. Z. Oh, he's mine, all mine. We start in a gentle lope. He spots the herd, and the way he tosses his head and neck, he's one cow pony happy to be back at work. I've spent the last 3 months getting to know Dr. Z, and now we're a team with me, the head honcho, which is pretty amazing. This 1,500-pound tank of muscle, a prey animal, the largest eyes of any land mammal on either side of his head, primed to flee from danger, has accepted me, a myopic apex predator who smells like the meat I eat, as his leader. I look right, Z takes me right. I look left, we veer left. Little squeeze of my thighs, we pick up speed. Lean back, ho, and we stop on the proverbial dime. And then we're loping again, all muscle and readiness. Tonight is my night, we're winning this one. Suddenly, Z slows to a walk. Hey, come on, pick it up, boy. He turns right. Hey! He crosses the arena and stops in front of Jimmy, our veterinarian. Hey, Diane, you're supposed to be warming up. There a problem?
I don't know. Z is not listening. He has a mind of his own.
Oh! I have the worst headache of my life. Surely only a lightning bolt could feel like this. But the starry night sky is clear. I know, and Z knows too, sensed before I had a clue. Come along for the rest of the story.